This is the HackRF Portapack, a handheld SDR transceiver capable of manipulating radio waves, decoding digital signals, and giving you an insight into the invisible electromagnetic world around us. It does, however, suffer from a huge flaw that can render it apparently completely unable of receiving anything. I broke my HackRF and I didn't even realize it at first. That's how easy it is to do accidentally. To explain what the problem is, I first have to talk about how the HackRF works. When you use a receiving application on the Portapack, you have three controls for adjusting the strength of your signal, which is also called gain in radio language. If you do not adjust these, you might not receive anything or have a worse than ideal reception. The gain settings affect different steps of the signal path in the receiver. The first option is LNA, which is short for low noise amplifier, and it's placed at the intermediate frequency stage of the receiver. This is the main gain adjustment to get a good signal to noise ratio. The second option is VGA, which is short for variable gain amplifier, and it's located at the baseband stage. This can be used to fine-tune levels, but it also amplifies signal noise. I think of this more as a volume adjustment into the application. The number values of these two settings define how much they gain the signal in dB, which is short for decibel and is a measurement value used, among other things, for radio signal strength. You will need a good balance of these two settings to get good decodes in the different apps. Start out with both values at 16 and increase them roughly equally to find the best settings for your situation. Too low of a gain and the signal will disappear in noise, and too high of a gain and you might get a distorted signal or ghost signals turning up in incorrect places. If you push the DFU button on the top of the HackRF Portapack twice, it will open a debug menu that, among other things, shows RX saturation percentage. RX is a commonly used radio abbreviation for receive, whereas TX would be transmit. This receive saturation percentage shows you how much signal is going into the decoding application and can help you adjust the signal strength so that it doesn't peak out at 100% or is too low at 0%. Press the DFU button once more to close the window after having adjusted your gain settings. There is a third setting called Amp. This can be toggled on or off, and controls a low noise amplifier, which is placed just near the antenna connector on the HackRF. When enabled, this will boost the incoming signal strength by a fixed amount of about 11 dB. This amplifier is the main problem of the HackRF, because it is extremely sensitive, and it can very easily be destroyed without you even knowing what caused it. It takes less than a volt of electricity entering the antenna port to destroy the amp, which could be caused by something as simple as connecting an antenna cable with a bit of static voltage buildup, or even having a strong transmission nearby. To determine whether or not your amp has been fried, open the audio receiving application and tune to a known signal with the amp turned off, like a local FM broadcast station. Now turn the amp on. If the signal strength lowers significantly, this means your amp is broken, and it's now functioning as an attenuator instead of an amplifier. If the signal strength increases, then the amp is still working fine. Toggling the amp off bypasses it in the circuit. This means that even if your amp is broken, you can still use your HackRF. You just have to turn the amp off, otherwise you won't be receiving anything. And if your amp isn't broken, it is still best practice to have it be turned off by default, unless you actually need it. Be careful what you connect to your HackRF. Turn the HackRF off while connecting and disconnecting antennas. And if you connect outside antennas, make sure to ground them first so that you remove any static buildup. It is also possible to use external low noise amplifiers instead of the built-in one, like this 20 dB amp from OpenSourceSDR Lab, which is powered by a USB cable. And of course, the best thing you can do to increase signal strength is to use a proper antenna for the frequency you're trying to listen to, and to have it up high and clear of surrounding buildings, trees or hills, and local noise sources.
Now, if you have steady hands and are really good at soldering, you can replace the broken part on the circuit board. But it can just as easily be fried again in the future. So there isn't really a good solution to this problem. Or is there?
HackRF is an open source hardware project. Just like open source software projects, where you can download the source code and build it yourself, this means that the plans for building a HackRF are freely available on GitHub, and anyone can source the parts and build one. While Michael Osman from Great Scott Gadgets is the designer of the board and also sells HackRF from his website, there are also third-party manufacturers who are making HackRF boards from the same design files. Just like open source software projects, there have been small changes to the design over the last 10 years that the project has existed. This is why you see boards sold that are labeled R9, for instance, indicating that it is revision 9 of the design. Mostly these changes have been done to make sure that all the components on the board are ones that are readily available for purchase currently. And just like open source software projects, you can also fork a hardware project and make design changes. One such design fork is made by a guy named Clifford Heath, and he has redesigned the circuitry around the problematic amp, along with a few other changes of components and minor improvements. By introducing a few protective diodes in the circuit, the amp is protected from voltages above its operating limits. This prevents the amp from being fried by simple static discharges and even higher voltages entering the antenna port. So far, I've only been talking about the receiving chain of HackRF. But the same model of amp chip is used in the transmitting section and can be toggled on or off in transmitting applications. This second transmitting amp is less likely to be damaged normally, but the Clifford version of the HackRF circuit board also puts in protection of this transmit amp. You can get the Clifford edition of the HackRF board separately, or in this assembled Portapack version that OpenSourceSDR Lab has kindly sent me.
I've had this for a while now, and I've not managed to break the amp. And even with the amp turned off, it seems like it's better at receiving than my old HackRF. I'll link to where you can buy this one down below, and I hope I've given you a small insight into the potential pitfalls of the HackRF.